I heard there was a secret test to see if a mean differs from the rest. But you don't really care which one, do ya? It could be this, the fourth, the fifth, a minor spread, the mean's adrift. The baffled students should know, use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Difference was large, but you needed proof. Sigma helps you avoid a goof. The ratio of the variances will show ya. Deviations in each group are squared. Variances of the means compared. The fraction is how to use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Based on the null hypothesis, the mean in each analysis, in every group it will be the same true mu. If you get a small p-value, look at the group you belong to prove the mean changes. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. HA says means are not the same. Not all the means are different claim. It might be only one mean looks new to ya. When means differ, the F is large. Fisher was the guy in charge. A small p-value when you use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Maybe there are two variables, categorical and numerical. Who knows if they are independent, do ya? Random and normal, the data must be. Equal variance, you must see. That's the assumption to use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Testing with a sigma to pool. T-test is not the only rule. This method you will use over ANOVA. With many X's, it's your intention to test the slope in regression. For all these types of problems, use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Each group has a unique sigma. Equal means is the enigma. Analysis of covariance will do ya. If X is in multiple dimension, testing means has your attention. There is a method you can use. ManCoVa. Use ManCoVa. Use ManCoVa. You not in this class, okay? That is way beyond what we are doing here. In here? Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA. Use ANOVA.